Yo dog, I heard you like carbon fiber. So I put carbon fiber in your carbon fiber filament so you can add carbon fiber while you print with carbon fiber. Yeah, that's pretty much the idea with Markforged ONYX filament if you use it with some extra continuous carbon fiber. The ONYX itself is nylon-based and contains a liberal amount of chopped carbon fiber. It's made specifically for the Markforged line of 3D printers and comes with a hefty price tag of around 314 euros per kilogram, making it by far the most expensive filament included in the filament series yet. The continuous carbon fiber is used as longer loops in strategic locations of the prints, but does clock in at around 2500 euros per kilogram. While there's not much keeping you from using the 1.75 mm ONYX in other machines, I printed it with the Mark II using settings that closely match what I use on the other episodes. Markforged uses a print temperature of 275 degrees Celsius and an unheated but enclosed bed with a Gerolite surface covered with glue stick. Just like other nylon filaments, ONYX is very hygroscopic and needs to be kept in this airtight dry box. As expected from an integrated ecosystem, this results in clean and crisp prints with the 3D Benchy and the overhangs test coming out flawlessly, no stringing but slightly mangled tips on the fine details parts, and decent bridging results, netting the ONYX Plus Mark II combo a very good 18 out of 20 quality score. When it comes to the strength of the printed parts, the overall slightly increased flexibility over standard plastics and the high elongation at break means that the bend tests didn't really fail, they just kinked and mostly sprung back into shape. What's really interesting here as well is that even the pull test rings didn't fail at the max load used in the filament test, which puts the Markforged ONYX at the very top of the scoreboard, though again, as this wasn't printed with the exact usual test setup, this isn't perfectly comparable, but very impressive nonetheless. Now let's add a few continuous carbon fibers into the mix. As the machine had trouble finding space for extra fibers in the vertically printed parts, where fibers parallel to the layers wouldn't have helped much anyways, I only tested the horizontal parts. Even with only a light quantity of continuous fiber, the increase in stiffness was immediately noticeable and the deflection at a 1 kg load only reads a quarter of pure ONYX. The amount of continuous fiber was roughly the same as in this quadcopter frame printed with transparent nylon instead of ONYX. While the continuous fiber reinforced part did put up a better fight, it did still eventually kink, supposedly tearing the continuous fibers inside. The pull test did actually snap this time, but did so while keeping its shape much better than the pure ONYX part, which only survived after deforming a large amount. And just as the icing on the cake, the heat resistance of ONYX is about comparable to ABS, which means it's only ever so slightly softening up in boiling water. So while these materials are definitely not something you'd want to use as a substitute for PLA, ONYX and the continuous carbon fiber, and for that matter the other fibers like glass fiber or Kevlar, offer exceptional performance all around. And if you have the right application, a 3D printed part using continuous fiber reinforcement can definitely compete with parts machined from solid aluminum. And that's worth something on its own.